follow you forever, so treasure your vow. Dane and Scott have written these, their own vows, and I invite them to say them. Dane, would you please offer your vow to Scott?
I do. Thank you all for coming. Scott, I thought about all the words I could possibly use to describe.
And I'm so confident.
Over 2 years ago, you slipped me a post-it note with those words on it to tell me you love me for the first time. We're still writing post-it notes for each other, and those are still the best words to describe how I feel about you. Oh, thank you. But I have a few more to add. It astounds me how well matched we are for each other in every aspect. You are the funniest, smartest, most hardworking, and loving you has made a difference. Loving you has changed me in so many ways. My love for you surrounds every part of my life. I am more motivated, more optimistic, more complete since I fell in love with you. I know I told you, not very long ago, that I didn't want to get married. But luckily, I changed my mind. I am marrying you. Because I want to stand up in front of all my loved ones and tell them and the whole world that you and I are a team, paired, partners for life, that you are the most important person in the world to me. Scott, I vow to be the best partner I possibly can. I vow to listen, to talk, to always keep an open mind. I vow to nurture our love with respect and devotion and work to keep our bond as strong as possible. I vow to be your partner in all respects and support you in all ways. I vow to be passionate, adventurous, and adaptive. I vow to make the most of every moment we spend together, to cherish every day, and I'm lucky enough to spend with your wife. Roger Ebert once wrote of his wife, "You are my horizon." That you are my horizon. From this day forward, you are my husband, and you fill my life.